Okay, I did mine on the case of Anna O, which is like, it leads to psychoanalysis, which it talks about the approach of psychoanalytic treatment. First, I'm going to talk about who Anna O is. She was also known as Bertha Pappenheim. She was the main caregiver for her father. He was very ill, and she nursed him until he died, passed away. She fell mentally ill right after his death. She was taken away from him and keeping from his conditions, and that caused her father's death caused her to fall mentally ill. She didn't get treated until she developed a cough like her father's. And so Joseph Brewer was their family doctor. The family decided to take her in, and he was called in to treat her. Joseph Brewer was Sigmund Freud's colleague. He played a huge role in discovering the basis of psychoanalysis. And the psychoanalysis is treating mental disorders while focusing on both the conscious and unconscious mind. The Anna O case was one of Joseph Brewer's most influential pieces of work. Now we're going to talk about the case. This was a famous study in the history of psychoanalysis. Once the case was started, Anna O was diagnosed with hysteria. Brewer spent 2 hours a day with her trying to cure her hysteria, and he treated her with hypnosis, and it wasn't curing her completely, so he moved on and was starting to allow Anna to speak about whatever she wished, and this improved her communication, and it swept her symptoms away, and it led to research on hallucinations and increased the growth of use of talking therapy. Sigmund Freud played a huge role in this as well, and the talking therapy is one of his greatest contributions to psychology. And after the case concluded, Freud went into private practice to try to treat his patients with hysteria. Most of them were females. He used Faradism, which is also known as electrotherapy. It was his main use, and it was his most successful use of treatment. He tried using other therapies like warm baths and magnetic cures, but they were not successful. He tried to do hypnosis like Brewer, but it wasn't successful either because he wasn't a natural hypnotist, so his patients weren't, they were rejecting to go under. This developed the talking cure or the talking therapy. It helps minimize the problems by he allowed the patients to talk about their problems to help minimize them. And it allowed him to lay into their deep unconscious minds. In conclusion, so 12 years later, after the case concluded, Freud met up with Brewer and they discussed about writing up the case of Anna O. Brewer wasn't agreeing with it. He wasn't sure about writing it up because it made a huge impact on him, and he just was over the case because it influenced him really bad. I wouldn't say a negative way, but he was just ready to be done with the case because it impacted him. So Brewer finally gave in and started writing up the case, and it played a huge role in their book that they co-wrote, Studies on Hysteria, and it was published in 1937. Freud is known to say that the case is the true founder of the psychoanalytic approach to mental health treatment, and it played a big incentive for Sigmund Freud moving into more of a psychological.
How Like, what made you decide to do your entire presentation on Canada?
I've been really interested in mental health and like psychoanalysis. I keep getting those two words mixed up. Psychoanalysis, and it's just been really interesting.
Were there any cool controversies surrounding this case that you came across?
Controversies? The ones when I researched it,